What we have here is a partial routine for computing matrix vector multiplication in terms of dot products. The parameters being passed in are the matrix sizes, M and N, the address of where the matrix is stored, as well as the leading dimension of the array, and then the address of where X is stored, the increment that tells you how to get from one element of X to the next, and then the same thing for vector Y. The way I like to go about this is to start by making a picture, and I've already done that here. Now, the loop here is over the rows of A. So what we've identified here is the row indexed with I, with which we're now going to do the dot product. And the question now is, what parameters to pass in to the dot product? The first parameter in the dot product is the size of the vectors with which you're going to perform a dot product. And notice that in this particular case, that's n. Next, you need to determine the address of where the first vector that's part of the dot product starts. Let's see where that is. It's this element right here. And if you think about that, that's the I0 entry in A. And the I0 entry in A is stored at the address ampersand alpha of I comma 0. So you fill that in. Next, you need to determine how you're going to march from one element in the vector to the next. How are you going to get from one element to the next? And you remember that that is given by the leading dimension of A. So you fill that in. Then you need to pass in the address of where vector X starts, and that's just X itself because it's being passed in as that address, and the increment with which you have to march through memory to get from one element of X to the next. And that was passed in as the parameter incx. And then finally, you need to determine what element of Y needs to be updated. Now notice that that's the ith element of Y, and the ith element of Y is given by psi of I, but you need to pass in the address of that so that it can be updated, and therefore you pass in ampersand psi of I. So hopefully now you understand how such a routine should be written, but importantly, hopefully you also understand the process by which you can determine what the different parameters are that need to be passed in.